Hello everyone, welcome to my channel tutel.com. Today the topic that we are going to discuss is acceleration. So if you want to have a look at other videos like speed, velocity, distance, displacement, scalar and vector quantities, you can just log on to site www.tutel.com or subscribe to the channel and check out the playlist. So if you have not subscribed till now, I would suggest please do. And after the video is over, please do like our video if you like it. Now, acceleration, suppose that there is a person who's moving in this direction and with a constant speed and he applies a brake suddenly. So in which direction do you think he'll move? He'll move in the forward direction. Now, if this person is taking a turn, so the direction of the turn is right, so he'll move in the left direction. In both of the cases, I'll say that the acceleration is happening. Now, if there is any vehicle and there is change in the velocity, then there is acceleration. What is change in velocity? Now, we have already studied that velocity is speed plus direction. So, the change in the velocity would be either a change in the speed or a change in the direction. If there is change in either one of these or both of these, then we can say that the body is accelerating. Now, look at these examples carefully. Now, in the first case, the car is moving on a straight path with a constant speed of 80 km per hour. Now, the two things which needs to change for the acceleration to happen is the speed and the direction. I'm just putting S and D for that. So, in the first case, since the direction is same, that is a straight path, so the direction is not changing. And we have been given that there is a constant speed of 80 km per hour. That means that the speed is also not changing. So in case one, we do not have an acceleration. Now let's see case two. So there is a constant speed again. So in case two, the speed is not changing. Now what about the direction? See, for now, the direction which can be seen here is a straight line. So the direction is also not changing. So we can say that in both of these cases, since there is no change in the velocity, there is no acceleration that is happening. Now let's see another case. In case A, I can see that the ball, it changes its speed after 5 seconds. So now in 5 seconds, the speed has increased from 0 to 20. So it would have been 1 here, 2 here, 3 here. So initially it has been 0 and then finally it is 20. That means that there is change in the speed. Now it's direction. Since it's going towards the west, so there is no change in the direction. As I have already said that even if they change in one of the components, that is either the speed or the direction, then we would say that there is change in velocity. So yes, in case A, acceleration is happening. Now let's see case two. So here, if I say that the car is moving at a constant velocity of, let's say, 20 km per hour. Now let's not go at my writing. Till now we have understood that I don't have a stylus. So 20 km per hour. So in this case, the speed is constant. So I'll say that we have a constant speed, but the direction it is changing with respect to time. Yes, like here the direction was this, and in this case the direction was this. So the direction is changing. That means that there is change in the velocity, but there is no in the direction, but there is no change in the speed. So altogether there is change in velocity, and hence this in case B also the car is having an acceleration. I hope the acceleration part is clear to you. It's very important that you get this. So acceleration is defined as a rate of change of velocity. So whenever you get the word rate of, that means that in the denominator we have time. So and in the numerator we have the word just after of. So it is change in velocity divided by time. Now change in velocity is initial velocity is demonstrated by the letter u and the final is demonstrated by v. So change in velocity would be v minus u, that is final velocity minus initial velocity. So we will have the formula as a equals v minus u upon t. Now initial velocity will, if the question says that initially the body was at rest, then the initial velocity would be zero, whatever the unit of the question is. Now let's summarize what we have learned so far. So acceleration is when there is either change in speed or change in direction or both. So even if the speed and direction both are changing, then also the body is said to be in acceleration. Like if I had a car which goes like this, and the direction is changing, and since it will be applying brakes at different intervals, so the speed is also changing. In this case also, the body is said to be in acceleration. The formula for to calculate acceleration is change in velocity divided by time. I hope the concept is clear to you. Next, we will be covering uniform and non-uniform acceleration. Please stay tuned. And if you have not subscribed, do subscribe. You can visit our site www.tutel.com for 1 to 12 science and maths material. And you will also get question answers, which if you answer, you will be graded as soon as you submit those. Thank you so much. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Take care. Bye-bye.